Fact or follow-up segment tonight. Last night, Charles Krauthammer criticized a former Princeton University professor, Dr. Stephen Cohen, for writing an article in The Nation magazine. It says the American media is not accurately reporting on Putin and Russia. One of the issues in the article is the trouble in Ukraine. Today, at least 18 people killed in Kiev, protesting Ukraine's failure to enter the EU and other things. Putin does not want that, yet many Ukrainians believe it would help the bad economy in that country. The protests are getting worse, and the U.S. government is siding with the dissenters. Because we're a fair program, we invited Dr. Cohen, the subject of last night's Krauthammer segment, on this evening. Joins us from New York City. All right, doctor, it appears that Putin is stifling Ukraine. Do you see it that way?
No. Ukraine is not one country, it's two countries. One leans toward Russia, one toward Western Europe. You wouldn't know it from the American press. But you tell me, why did the European Union, backed by the Obama administration, tell Ukraine, the democratically elected president, whether you like it or not, Yanukovych, in November, that Ukraine had to choose between Russia and the West? That was to precipitate the kind of civil war and violence we're now seeing in the streets. Why not instead?
Well, Krauthammer says.
Why not instead?
Wait.
All right, sorry.
I'm not going to get involved in EU politics. That's ridiculous. All right? But the overarch on this is that Putin has his boot on the neck of the democratically elected president. That the people in Ukraine know it, they don't like it, and that's why we're seeing the scenes we're looking at right now. But let's broaden the discussion to Putin himself.
All right.
Do you consider him a tyrant?
No. An authoritarian leader.
All right, now let me stop you there. Yep. He's a former KGB guy.
Yeah.
All right? He backs the mullahs in Iran.
Yeah.
He backs Assad in Syria, who's a killer. And you don't consider him a tyrant? He throws journalists in jail. He passes anti-gay legislation. Right. I mean, what does it take in your mind to be a tyrant, doctor?
I don't know. I guess Saudi Arabia and many American allies qualify, but I see the issue differently. I see the United States having more dangerous problems in the world than we had during the Cold War. I see Russia as a potential partner in alleviating those dangers, and I see the kind of Putin bashing that's going on by Charles Krauthammer last night, for example, as an obstacle to American national security. That's the patriotic position to take. A patriot for American national security requires Obama or whoever is the American president cooperating with the Russians. They are our best
All right.
potential
So you
partner.
See him, you see Putin as a potential solution to some world problems that we
yep.
shouldn't exacerbate
yep.
by attacking him.
Yep.
I disagree with you. And I'm going to go by the United Nations report that in Syria, there are 100,000 civilians killed by the Assad regime. And Putin gave that regime $1 billion worth of arms last year alone. In my mind, Putin is a murderer that you don't get in bed with because he might be able to lessen some tensions in someplace else.
All right, so
come
put,
on.
So all right, so put a conflicting idea in your mind. Putin and Putin alone compelled Assad to destroy his chemical weapons, which we were very worried
yeah.
about in August. So does he get any
And he did it because he didn't want the United States to militarily move against Assad, thereby getting him out of power.
Well, if that
That's not a heroic action.
Well, if you were right about that, then Obama would have got him to do it. It took Putin to get him to do it. Do we credit him for that?
I'm not going to give Putin credit until, number one, we know that all of those things are out of there.
All right.
Because I believe that Putin is a murderer, is a killer and a human rights violator who supports the most vicious regimes on this earth. Now, sometimes you gotta do business with the devil. I mean, I understand that, I'm not naive. But I don't think the American press, including me, has inaccurately reported Vladimir Putin. I'll give you the last word.
There is no last word, but let me refer you to your colleague on the right, if it's right saying you're on the right, Pat Buchanan. He thinks Putin, he's fallen in love with Putin. He thinks Putin is one of the great conservatives and that his values should be American values. So there's a dispute about who Putin is, and I guarantee you, Mr. O'Reilly, that when you and I are long and gone, historians will be debating for decades the pluses and minuses of Vladimir Putin.
All right. And number one, I don't have any colleagues on the right or on the left.
I don't
or
either.
In any ideology. I don't come at it that way.
I don't either.
All right. Okay. And it was a very interesting discussion, Doctor. We appreciate your point of view.
That just made us colleagues, by the way.
All right. Directly ahead, a factor investigation.